Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we are talking about the best basic bolt-on modifications for the 7.3 PowerStroke. There are four basic modifications that can easily add over 100 horsepower and 200 torque to the 7.3 PowerStroke relatively safely and reliably. Now, the 7.3 is an extremely reliable engine. However, it's not necessarily the greatest with respect to high horsepower builds because there are a number of limiting factors with it. But regardless of all of that, there are some basic bolt-ons that you can do to your truck to add a lot of power, get better gas mileage, lower your EGTs, and overall turn your truck into a better towing truck and make it run more reliably and healthier. Things start to get really expensive once you start talking about pushing 400 or 400 plus wheel horsepower on the 7.3 PowerStroke. So we're gonna talk about all of the basic modifications that can get you up to those levels, but we're gonna save all of the more advanced modifications for a later video. And here, just focus on the basic bolt-ons for the average 7.3 owner who's looking for better gas mileage, better towing, more power, and so forth. First, before we jump into it, just from a power limit standpoint, it's helpful to understand where the roadblocks are and at what power levels you have to start upgrading certain components. For the 7.3, the first limitation you're going to reach is with the factory fuel injectors. Those are good for about 350 wheel horsepower before you need to upgrade them. With upgraded fuel injectors, the factory fueling system can handle about 375 to 400 wheel horsepower before you're gonna need fueling upgrades. Also at that 400 wheel horsepower limit is the stock turbocharger and the stock transmission. And so that's really why pushing beyond 400 gets very expensive, is you're gonna need a lot of fueling upgrades, you're gonna need turbo upgrade, transmission upgrades, and a number of other bolt-on modifications as well. The mods that we're gonna cover are going to be able to put you pretty conservatively in the 300 to 325 wheel horsepower range, which is what I would consider a safe limit without having to look into injector upgrades, transmission upgrades, and all of the more expensive modifications. So these are four great modifications to get an extra 100 plus horsepower out of your truck without putting you into territory where you're gonna have to spend a lot of money on upgrades. So the first thing is tuning. Now, tuning is a little bit different on the 7.3. The 7.3 responds a lot better to chip tuning rather than traditional programmers. So the best tuner out there is PHP Hydra. It can support custom tuning, but it also comes preloaded with six different tunes that can add anywhere from 25 to 140 horsepower. The PHP Hydra also supports custom tuning. It's probably the most popular platform that custom tuners use. It's a great addition to add right away. You can add PHP Hydra, you can run some of the base tunes, and then once you get further into modifications, or if you really want to dial things in, you can then opt for custom tuning. The best part about PHP Hydra that you don't get with all of the other chips out there is you can remotely upload new tunes to it whenever you get custom tuning done. With the other things out there on the market, like the TS6, you have to actually take the board and ship the board in and get that reburned whenever you want new tunes. PHP Hydra is hands down the best. It's like $399 to get started and is gonna be the best bang for the buck, the most power you're gonna get out of any of these modifications. And really everything else that we talk about from here is to support the tuning and to support the turbo. So the second best modification is gonna be a cold air intake. Tuning really creates more power by increasing the pressure that the turbocharger is running at. And to help alleviate some stress on the turbocharger, it's important to now bring more air into the engine and more air to the turbocharger. You're gonna see some power gains usually in about the 10 to 20 wheel horsepower range with tuning, but you're also gonna get a number of other benefits like faster turbo spool. You'll see a small 1 to 2 mile per gallon increase in fuel economy as well. An intake is a great supporting modification for tuning. You get power out of it, you get throttle response, and you actually get some gas mileage benefits, which is a great factor. considering the 7.3 doesn't have great gas mileage. Here's our boosted performance 7.3 power stroke intake system. We've got a really high quality S&B filter along with a nice finish on the piping. This sells for $249 over at Boosted Performance. We get great performance gains out of this. So go ahead and head on over there if you're looking for an intake system and use the code DIESELIQ to save 10% off on our Boosted Performance intake, as well as 5% off on any of our other resale products. The third thing on the list is a turbo back exhaust system. Now that we've got our tuning taken care of and we have an intake that's bringing more air into the engine, we now have to get rid of all of that air as quickly as possible. When the air can't escape out of the exhaust fast enough, that creates back pressure within the exhaust system. That back pressure then acts as a force against the turbocharger, so it makes it harder for the turbocharger to spool, which in turn results in a less reliable as well as a less efficient turbocharger. So upgrading to a turbo back exhaust system is the best way to free up the exhaust gases, help reduce any pressure that's operating against the turbocharger, therefore then reduces your EGTs because your turbo is going to be running cooler. It also adds horsepower because you now have a more efficient turbocharger, and you get some nice sounds out of it as well. An exhaust system is going to lower your EGTs by about 150 to 200 degrees. So this is certainly one of the best reliability modifications you can do to keep your EGTs low. For anyone running the factory turbo, a good 4-inch exhaust system is perfect. You can get the 5-inch, but you really don't need a 5-inch unless you're running an upgraded turbocharger. We always recommend avoiding a muffler just because the muffler creates some back pressure as well, albeit it does also reduce the sounds a little bit. And additionally, aluminum systems are cheaper than steel. Steel ones are gonna last longer and not rust out as easily, but the steel ones do create a little bit more drone just because of the material. I tend to prefer an aluminum one anyways, just because it's cheaper and it sounds better. The best bang for the buck on the market's the MBRP 4-inch turbo back aluminum exhaust. It's only $420, and you're gonna see really good EGT drops out of it. You're gonna see some power gains and overall a healthier and more efficient turbocharger. And the last thing on the list is more of a controversial one, but it's a boost fooler. The PCM on the 7.3 starts to defuel somewhere around 22 to 24 PSI of boost. If you try boosting above that, you'll notice that the truck is pulling fueling and is not performing as it should. And so once you're tuned and running above 24 PSI, you need to address the issue with defueling. Now, the way that you do this is through a boost fooler. The boost fooler essentially tells the PCM that the turbo is running at 22 PSI and is never running above 22 PSI so that the PCM doesn't ever pull fueling. A lot of tuners will tell you that they tune around it and that you don't need a boost fooler because the tuning takes care of all of it. But we always recommend running a boost fooler anyways. The reason being, when you tune around it and eliminate the overboosting code that you get, you basically pull all of the low boost fueling. And what that does, while it might not be noticeable, it ultimately causes your truck to run not as well as it would run if you did have a boost fooler. If you're not running a boost fooler, but you're tuned and your tuner tells you you doesn't need one, I promise you, you will see a big difference in your truck's performance and overall how well it runs by installing a boost fooler. So that covers it for our four basic modifications. We've got tuning, a cold air intake, a turbo back exhaust, and a boost fooler. All of these products can be purchased for $1,100 and can add upwards of 140 or 150 horsepower. There's a few other things to consider quickly. You'll probably want gauges or a digital monitor like the Insight CTS3 to help read EGT temperatures, trans temps, and other things like that, just to make sure boost pressure temperatures are all staying within range. Intercooler upgrades are a great thing to add if you do a lot of towing. They're not necessarily required at these power levels, but I have a Banks Power intercooler on my 7.3, and it's certainly a fantastic upgrade for EGTs and for reliability. Another thing is injectors. If you have old injectors, you might start to run into injector issues after you do all of these modifications. Upgrading to stage 1 or stage 1.5s is probably a good idea if your factory injectors are on the way out and you have to replace them anyways. And then an H-pop upgrade or the high pressure oil pump is another thing that will help with reliability and will help free up some power as well, but isn't something that's necessarily required or I would say even recommended at just these basic bolt-on power levels. Once you start pushing beyond this, that's when you're looking at probably 10 grand plus in upgrades to really get to the 400 to 450 wheel horsepower mark reliably. There you're gonna need a turbo upgrade, you're gonna need a built transmission, you're gonna need an H-pop, injectors, fuel system upgrades, as well as all these bolt-on modifications that we're talking about. These trucks are pretty expensive to get to those power levels, and really pushing them anything beyond 450 is when it starts to get extra expensive. One of the best things I think with the 7.3 is to throw these four modifications on there and be happy with the 300 to 325 wheel horsepower that you're pushing. Unless you have a big budget and you're trying to do a pretty crazy high horsepower build, you certainly can do it. It's just expensive, and the 7.3 is not quite as favorable as a platform for modifications compared to some of the other diesel engines of the time out there. Anyways, guys, that wraps it up for our video on the 7.3 PowerStroke. I'll go ahead and dive into all of these other modifications in separate videos and show you the setup that I've got on my 7.3 F350. If you appreciate this content, please subscribe and stay tuned for our future videos.